Classic. So we were discussing chapter 8, human body nervous system. We have already discussed about brain and spinal cord and its function, right? So we were discussing about the function of spinal cord. As we know, the main function of the spinal cord is to carry out reflex action. Now what is reflex action? Reflex action means immediate action carried out when encountering a certain stimulus without the knowledge of a brain. It's referred to as reflex of action. Reflex action is carried out without brain being involved. Okay, brain will be made to know about the action only after you have carried out the action. Okay, so here you do not have the involvement of brain, only spinal cord is involved. Okay, so the immediate action is referred to as your reflex action, immediate or spontaneous action. Okay, example would be if I place a hot water in front of you and you did not know that it's a hot water, if you just go and touch the vessel, what would be your first reaction? You would immediately remove your hand. Okay, so that's a spontaneous action. Without you yourself being informed about it, you remove your hand, right? So it's a reflex action. Okay, now another term is reflex arc. What is reflex arc? Reflex arc tells you about the nervous pathway through which is carried out, through which the impulse travel for carrying out the reflex action. Okay, so your nervous pathway will be, first there should be any change in the environment. For example, the hot water placed in front of you, you touch it with your hand. So skin has certain receptor, hormone receptor. Okay, it senses that there's a heat which is above your bearable rate. Okay, so it is sensed by the receptor. Now receptors are linked with the sensory neuron. Now sensory neuron will send the message to the brain. Okay, instead of taking the message to our brain, instead of taking the message to the brain, it will take the message to the sensory neuron, will take the message to the spinal cord. Okay, now from spinal cord to association neuron, then you have motor neuron. The function of the motor neuron we know, right? But it takes the message to the effector organs. The effector organs in your case would be your hand, okay? Because it would immediately remove itself from that particular region when it finds a threat. Okay, so effector organ, the motor neuron will take the message to the effector organ. So this whole pathway through which your nerve impulse travel is referred to as a reflex arc. Okay, now reflex action are of two types: natural reflex action and you have conditioned reflex action. Okay, natural reflex action means the one you are born with. Nobody has to teach you. Okay, or no, you do not learn it from the experience. For example, if you throw a paper to the infant or a child, what happens? He immediately blinks his eyes. Okay, those knee jerk, all these are the natural reflex action. Okay, now there are certain reflex actions, okay, which you learn with the experience. Those are referred to as conditioned reflex action. Okay, now in order to understand about the conditioned reflex action, one of the scientists named Ivan Pavlov, he carried out an experiment with dog. Okay, so in order to understand the conditioned reflex action, so what did he do is, his model of study was dog. Okay, so he had the dog. Okay, in the first step, what did he do? He presented a food to the dog. Okay, as soon as dog saw the food, it started salivating. Okay, now next, what happened was, next day he just rang the bell and then dog didn't salivate. Okay, third day, what did he do? He rang the bell and then he presented the food to the dog, and he continued this for a few days. Okay, now after a few days, what did he do was, He rang the bell, but he did not present the food. But what did he saw in the change in the behavior of a dog? He saw that the dog, as soon as he heard the bell ringing, the dog started salivating. Okay, so what does this prove? That dog has associated the bell with the food. Okay, so this dog has learned with the experience that as soon as he hears the bell ringing, he will get a food. So this reflex action was brought into occurrence by certain experience. Okay, because initially when only the bell, when the scientist rang the bell, he did not salivate, but with experience he associated the bell with the food, because after that what happens, as soon as the bell rang, he got the food. So he thought bell means he will get the food, that's why he started salivating. So this is conditioned reflex. Okay, here you are learning with the experience. Okay, this we can see now day to day life also, right? Now if we imagine about the food that we love, like momo or chow mein or puchka or pizza or anything that we love, what happens? We start salivating, because we know the taste. With experience we found that okay, those foods are good to taste. So as soon as you imagine about those food also, you start salivating. So this is conditioned reflex. That means with experience you are getting this reflex in action. Okay, so that's all about this chapter. Okay, next I'll call it with the question and answer from this chapter. You go through the previous video also in order to understand in detail about the nervous system. Okay, it's very much important to go through the function of the brain, different parts of the brain, spinal cord. Okay, so you go through it in detail. Thank you.